meter. See how he cancels and does it purposely just to build extra meter.
He actually makes Cabal look like he's having seizures.
if I remember correctly, I do think that Rio finishes this with a troll X-ray. I think.
Backing up instant airs, some blades.
You see, he's just zoning him out, trying to build meter. And if you guys know Rio, you know why he's building meter. See, that's that jump over fireball.
I was just going to say, from you telling me that before, it's the first. I always ask the wonder why the hell he would do that.
Yep, and he does it to build meter. And he has no need to do it now because he's got full meter. But, you know, all he's got to do is get him in position, and that's that. You know, that's going to be that Rio Troll X-ray.
Cyber Kang for Phil.
Instant air fireballs. Doing it all on a pad, by the way. Oh, wow. And Josh connecting with his X-ray.
But he's going to answer one with his.
And there it is. Troll X-ray for the win. I barely allow Liu Kang players in VSM. Okay, so I'm going to be setting up the next match. And while this match is going on, this is if I remember correctly. This is a button check.
I don't remember too many of the Barakas. Actually, I think Flip and Flavor did use Baraka.
Yeah, this is Flip and Flavor in a. I think it's Pool B. Flippin' Flavor versus VSM Maxter. And I'm going to call Dark Rob there in this match, so if you wouldn't mind calling the match. here we go. Flippin' Flavor versus VSM Maxter in a Pool B winner's bracket match.
He's managing his meter, but once you get caught in that trap, fell, dropped it. Oh, getting set up on the bomb. And it takes the first match, first round. Barack is more than cute. Fucking hot. Typically, Barack should be able to take this match since people like to put out of 10. I guess it would go 9-1 typically in Barack's favor. But we'll see how this turns out. Coming in with the down fours, but gets trapped by Cyrax in the corner now. But he gets out. A 9-1 Baraka, that's right. The only time it's a 1 is maybe if you play a Max Door or a Crazy. It's also 9-1 versus Sub-Zero. It looks like Phil had to he just texted me that he's got to go drop a deuce. So I don't know, if Junior, if you can get over here to bring a plunger. All right, so here we go. Once again, the down fours. Whiffing on the spin there. What's up there, Shock? And that's about doing it there for him. And he's back. That was a quick one.
Yeah, I figured I'll let you guys know that I just won my my winner's bracket match against the bathroom.
Anytime a match ends, yeah. If I'm not here, all you have to do is click scene 3.
Scene 3 work goes to this?
Now, this one is actually, it's quite a long one. There's like 13 minutes of matches here, and which pretty much turns out to be, it pretty much turns out to be that this is one of the times where they forgot to hit the stop recording button. So this match is... This match is Lionheart, and I'm trying to find what pool. This is Lionheart in the winner's bracket match against Pig of the Hut. So this is a pretty hype match. Everybody wanted to see Pig come play and do very well, and he did. He not only did very well, but this was also a... yes, Shock, this is everything that we recorded from NEC Pools. Unfortunately, Shock, as I was telling, as I told everybody on the stream already, you know how we were having driver issues with the sound, with the video card... or with the capture device, and it turns out that the audio was not really captured either on Saturday, so that's why we're doing this without any game audio and just doing live commentary. and then it resulted in all the problems that we had Sunday without being able to get any video. Once I connected it to the internet, we had the computer to the internet, it updated the drivers, and we were good to go again. But, so Pig of the Hut taking that first round, And Lionheart doing a decent job getting him down to, I would say, about 30% or 40% of his life left. Shock, with the way NEC went, basically, I wasn't quite prepared to begin recording when I did, because that's when Brady and Newbie started screaming from the corner, and then they did their money match, so I pretty much was just put on the spot to start recording.
Pig taking that one pretty convincingly.
Pretty convincingly, yeah. But to be 100% honest, I think I've got 99% of the kinks worked out. And as long as my drivers are fine, then everything works well every time now. So this is just this is a recording issue from this is just a recording issue from from the problem with the drivers on the capture card back then.
So Art, did you actually replace your phone yet or not yet? Make sure you get the Find My Phone app next time. Comes in handy sometimes. But I could tell you, it probably wasn't a Mortal Kombat guy that took it. Most likely a Street Fighter guy.
Well, the good news is, Shock, that in the future it shouldn't be an issue, because more likely than not we'll have access to Red Rum's 4G air card, so we should be streaming it rather than just recording matches. So, you know, anytime I have to test the stream, you know, it pretty much gives me an idea of what's going on. The good part is that they don't really they pay. I think they pay for an unlimited 4G wireless card.
Yes.
This business that he does, he's with. So as you can see, Pig of the Hut, pretty much taking that with authority. And we're gonna do a quick commercial here, guys. So. All right, so we're just waiting at this point. I'm getting the next match set up because, as I said, this is like 13 minutes of matches. So, oh, boy.
This was a random.
I think this was a button check. Yeah, it was definitely a button check. So I'll let everybody know what this match is in just a moment. Hold on just 1 second while I set up the match. Okay, so up next, I believe it's Pool B. Maybe not. Maybe it was Pool D. No? Or Pool... All right. So I guess we'll go all the way back to Pool A. There it is. So this is a Pool A, and it's actually our first loser's bracket match. And this is Ice Cold Edge versus... Toro Poo Poo, this is the theme song of VSM Paper Legend, in case you were wondering.
Don't worry about it, Art. We gave up on him.
Staying on the ground there, actually. As So Paper Legend, you were actually playing pretty well in this match.
You know,
did you foresee this? Did you see this coming in the future?
Like I said, the way I play, a lot of people might see me lose and say, man, this guy, he's garbage. You know, they'll troll me out like that. But I'm really just trying to lay out the bricks in the foundation for future players. So,
gotcha. So you're really, what you're doing is you're actually changing the future. You're coming back. You saw yourself winning. You came back to change the future.
Yes, because,
you wanted,
in the past, I had won all these tournaments already. Also, back when I was playing, they did have the two Evos in 1 year, and I won both of them.
All right. So we do have 1-1 now, Ice Cold Edge versus VSM Paper Legend, a.k.a. James M.K.
Not to make any excuses, I lost my matches because I lost my matches. But I don't suggest drinking for 24 hours straight before your matches. I'm puking.
What you guys didn't know is that Jimmy had bolted to the future, and it was New Year's Eve, and then he came back to play at NEC.
And it was not a good move to do. But not to take away from anybody I played, they still, they played well. You can only play if you're drunk. Everybody should be mandatorily have to drink before a tournament.
Well, your boy Johnny Cage wins. I mean,
yeah, we got us old school guys. Nitin knows, Summoning knows that us old school guys. You had to play half in the bag, or you couldn't play.
Oh well, let me tell you, Summoning gets better with every beer.
Yes, he does. A lot of guys can play better the more messed up they get.
he gets deadly in You might be able to slip past one of those any-air high punches in MK2, but
not,
with
not
every...
With him.
Oh,
not
my
with
God.
Him when he's in the bag now, you
oh
can't
Oh, my
past
God.
It.
See, you could have done more damage there.
Could have did more damage.
Yeah, a couple of punches and then
like the
EX hat. You didn't have the meter for the EX hat.
I was watching crowds and watching everything else but what I was actually doing, so I choked on my own. But, like I said, there was a point to this, and that's why Detroit got the belt.
So, unfortunately for everybody, as much as you enjoy the Paper Legend theme, this was Paper Legend's last stand at NEC. This is where he was eliminated.
Yes. So he wound up going on, grabbing a couple of six-packs and went back to the future. again.
All right. So we're going to be moving on momentarily. Got a quick commercial break. No, we don't. That's 8 minutes ago, so we'll wait on that. So, up next, now you guys asked for it, and here it is. This is, I believe, Pool D, or not. Here we go. This is Pool A, Morty Seinfeld. Versus Revolver. they're going to have a quick button check. Well, while they button check, let me just talk about Revolution X on January 22nd. At Yestercade in Red Bank, New Jersey, looking for 32 or more players, like a mini MK Major. Shock, can tell them all about it. It's actually, the pot bonuses you see have gone up, and we actually have more players, more money coming in than what you see currently on screen. Shock, you got to email me the updated graphics so that I can do it. There's actually more money involved than what you currently see on screen. And I'll update that graphic pretty soon. Yeah, those are my vicious birds, my evil little conyers. They're green cheek conyers. So, once again, Revolver and Morty Seinfeld. Okay, so sorry guys, I'm back. Obviously, as you can see, Morty, really just unbelievable, Sonya. after this match, I just have to update the graphic, which you guys will actually see as it happens, which kind of annoys me, but it is what it is. It's just the way XSplit works. Morty just staying on the ground for that, trying to zone out with the old pink onion rings. Nothing doing, and wow, does not win with the chip there, but the onion rings do. So one round away from beating Revolver. Oh, very cool, Art, that they're paying you guys to stream. Very nice. But Revolver really having a good round there. Very good match, very good round by Revolver, actually. So, Morty Seinfeld taking the match. But, you know, a good effort by Revolver. Best he could. You know, it is still Seinfeld. All right, guys, just hang on a second. I'm going to play a commercial. Okay, so now that you can see, we got the new banner up there. Revolution X, presented by Combat Network, January 22nd at Yestercades at 80 Broad Street in Red Bank. There will be a $400, $100, $125, and $75 minimum payout. This is being partially sponsored, obviously, by Local Battles, VSM, and Test Your Might. And yes, those payouts are minimum. Yeah, MKA is going to have some big pots at Revolution X. Anyway, the next match is another Pool A match. No, it's not. My bad. The next match is actually... That was actually a... sorry. I'm just kind of going along as I can. We had a little break in the action at NEC, so we had to have a little bit of some casual matches to fill the time. So the next match is actually Swift Tom Hanks versus Pig of the Hut. This is a Pool D winner's bracket match. And, of course, they're going to have... Let me just go back to that banner while this passes. Yeah, that's exactly what happened. Art, but part of the commotion of the beginning of this round was that Swift Tom Hanks wanted to go into the crypt and unlock Sektor's alternate costume. So that's why it took a little bit of extra time for me to get in there and get that done for you. But yeah, you guys are right. This is the same Swift Tom Hanks who knocked Tom Brady out of that local battles tournament, and you know Pig of the Hut actually taking that match pretty convincingly. Pig is just an outstanding player. Gonna be dangerous to see him at any major that he goes to. He could be top eight for a long time to come. Pig just trying to space it out, looking for his opportunity to use a roll. Just keeping the pressure on now. EX, nothing doing. Uppercut doesn't connect. Missile does, though. Almost had an opportunity there, but jump kick doesn't connect. Yeah, EX teleport kick, nothing following, though. And Pig takes the first round there. CD Jr., you should have been here to do some commentary. You too, Shock. Why are you guys not here for the New Year's Day special presentation? Standard bread and butter, ending with the bite. That's pretty much going to do it. Plant some, sigh. Yeah, and all you have to do is block to take that chip. Train to catch. And use the Metro card to transfer. Okay, so just stand by. Next match coming up soon. Okay, so we're back. The next match is actually Maddox versus VSM Crazy Dominican, and unfortunately, only the second match of it got captured. So I am going to play that for you. This is Maddox versus VSM Crazy Dominican. You know, just to give you guys an idea, you know, Crazy Dominican did win the first match of this. Back from the future again, I see.
Yes, I am. I had to go, go into the past to get real coffee.
Yes.
Who we got here? We got, Crazy.
Yeah, we got Maddox versus Crazy Dominican. Unfortunately, the first match, you know, the first match of the set was not recorded. So all they got was the second match. So, and Crazy Dominican, you know, he won the first match. But and this is actually a two-match set here. There's another one coming up. Wow, did you see that after the EX gets caught in the clone?
Wow.
See, yeah, this is just a tough matchup for Katana in general. I mean, for Sub-Zero in general. And
ends it with the down one.
Down one is going to do it.
There'd never be an EMP paper legend. It'll be VSM and that's it.
Okay, so the next match is 7L, and I think this is a Pool C match. This is now we have 7L versus Detroit Ballin'. Oh, wow. Shock went shredder on you.
Look at this. There was an Empire Perfect Legend.
Really? No, there was. There was an EMP Perfect Legend.
Yes, there was.
Oh, yeah, no, you're right. I think didn't he go back to EMP?
I believe he did.
Tricky Lizard, I explained this a couple of times. Basically, we were having some bad, we were having some driver problems with the capture card, and, you know, and the capture card, wow. 7L breaking there. We were having problems with the capture card, and I had to update the drivers, which I wasn't able to do while I was at the venue. So wow, that's a. I got to tell you, when looking at this, Revolver's Shang Tsung looks really good.
Yeah.
Revolver's Shang Tsung looks good now when I see this match.
Yeah, compared to this, yeah. I mean, I don't want to take nothing away from Detroit, but, you know, he was the first. So, Revolver seen it and approved upon it.
Yes.
Is No, I wouldn't call it.
Yeah, yes, actually, you're right. Conqueror was the first Shang. Wow, look at that combo and the setup.
I wouldn't call it Scrubby Shang. It was good. It was enough to earn my blessing. But I want to know how it would end with a Revolver Shang versus Detroit Shang.
Wow, that would be pretty intense.
Yeah. I think that could be a money match down in final round.
See, now he gets that damage boost for this round now. I don't think it's a full round. I think it's partial.
Yeah, partial. I think it's only like 15 seconds, which is plenty.
He just rushes and rushes. He just really, such a good job of setting everything up in this game. EX? No EX. All right, guys, quick commercial coming up. Okay, now we begin. We began, and I made a mistake on this because I was running them in the wrong order. Now that they're in the right order, everything helps. But now this is I believe this is a pool. Yeah, this is a pool D match. This is actually a Pool D quarterfinal match in the winner's bracket. This is VSM Ryu 48 versus TS Sabin, however the hell it's pronounced, Arturo. And, you know, what's funny is that Arturo, for whatever reason, always seems to meet Ryu 48 in tournament.
Yes.
Always meets him in tournament. See Arturo playing softball there, just taking a swing at taking a swing at everything that Sonya throws out at him. Both players just zoning each other, aren't really connecting there. Yeah, that's going to do it. Yeah, you know, Art, I promise you at Winter Brawl, I'll put Ryu 48 in a different pool. Yeah, I know, Art, but still, you know, you should definitely be playing him, you know, in top eight. I mean, at this point, you've played him so damn much, you know, that's a good round by Art right there.
How many did we have at NEC? About 80?
Yeah, I think it was 84. What's going on, Alex?
What's up, Alex? We already ran a couple of your videos.
Yeah, Alex, these are the pool matches from NEC. So we're about halfway through now, and we've been streaming for 3 hours.
Really? That long already?
Yeah,
wow.
Since 4:30. Almost 5. So we've been streaming Vegas for about 2.5, almost 3 hours.
Well, Art, you should stop playing some of that Street Fighter stuff and keep playing some MK down at VSM.
I think this week, after the Street Fighter Alpha money match, the Alpha 3 money match between this guy, Ruben, and myself, that's if he shows. If he shows.
Well, I did text you, Alex, so I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, so if he shows up and we get this this Alpha 3 money match in, then, wow, hell of a round. Good corner combo there by Ryu48. Then after that, I think we're going to run a little mini VSM tournament.
Sonya damage is pretty brutal.
Yeah, it is. And you know, Ryu48 right now is probably the second best Sonya out there. You know, second only to Morty Seinfeld, who is just insanely good. So we got a 1-1 going here right now. This might actually be a two-match thing as well. Not 100% sure. Up the, no living forest. Gonna go for the pit.
You don't have to worry about Dallas winning anything.
And Ryu just putting him in the corner and doing massive damage there. The EX cartwheel getting in. Wow, look at that Sonya damage.
Throw.
And yes. It's like, all right, come on, Reptile. You can get up now. It was payback time, huh, Art? Yeah, this was a fun tournament. I you know, you guys don't see me play except when I play UMK3, but running the pools and doing the recordings. This was fun. This was a really enjoyable tournament. You know, frustrating things notwithstanding, you know, my computer not working properly and not getting the ability to record on Sunday. You know, those are some frustrating things, but all in all, the Mortal Kombat 9 tournament was hell of a lot of fun to watch. It's going to be cool as hell to get Interloco at Revolution X, Shock. Ryu48 just trying to zone him out. Good neutral jump there by Art. 3-2-1. Slow ball. Dash in. But he stays on the ground. Dash in into a throw.
Sometimes the best move ain't to move at all.
Yep. That air throw. Art's heart is breaking right now.
It wasn't that bad.
All right, so let me set up the next match. Yeah, this one has a couple matches on it. Let's get through the button checks. Or are they right in? No, I think they're right in. All right. So the next match is, once again, I believe a Pool B match. Yeah, this is a Pool B. This is VSM Maxter versus Pimp Ouija. So we have a really good Scorpion versus a really good Cyrax.
How did Brady place in this? I forgot.
Ninth.
He always, you know, I hear guys bashing, but he's always there.
Yep.
Arturo's saying.
Maybe it was 13th. I think he did. Nah, maybe it was 13th. Oh, that's right. You're right. So he took 13th. That's actually, I think, his lowest placement ever. See, there he goes with that double teleport combination. Forward 2-1, jump over, forward 4 into spear. This should do it unless he has the ability to break, which he does. He drops that bomb. EX takedown misses, but he connects here, and this could do it. Wow. Doesn't drop the bomb, goes for the net instead. Takedown, nothing doing. Hellfire. Pimp Ouija on the verge of taking it. Teleports away. Down 1 beats
down
it, though.
One beats it.
Wow, round one goes to Pimp Ouija, making Maxter sweat. So we'll see how Maxter responds to that. Not happily, by the way. Let's see how he sets all this up. Yep, puts him in a trap, but and he's unable to teleport away from it. EX teleport, nothing doing on the second hit, though. Wow, standing four there. I bet you that was an input bug. And most high-level players don't look for that. Double teleport into down one spear. Jump over, forward 2-1, and Maxter has to break. Throw 1-1-1. Going with that pressure. Look at that pressure. Hellfire for the win. Pimp Ouija 1-0 over Maxter. Maxter in danger of being sent to losers here, actually. CD Jr., how is he doing, by the way? And Shock, are you going to Apex? That down one from Scorpion, taking out, knocking Maxter out of the air again. Teleport away. Now he's setting up into reset mode, but it doesn't work. He teleports away, throws him onto the ground with the air throw, wins the air-to-air with a jump kick. Bad teleport by Pimp Ouija, and he gets set up into a net. Back two, here comes the combo, drop the bomb. Ground saw instead, drops the bomb, jumps over, but the teleport gets him away. He gets out of the corner, though, with the air throw, sets up the net. This is going to do it. So Maxter responds in kind with a very impressive round over Pimp Ouija after Pimp Ouija takes the first match. Whoa, neutral jump into a combo. Jump over, forward, 2-1, teleport, jump over again into a leg takedown. Now he's got the advantage, but naked spear and he's going to get punished for it. This is going to do a lot of damage. EX bomb, sets it up, but he
pushed
him out by doing that uppercut. Teleport, EX teleport, into forward four spear. This could do some damage. Neutral jump, jump kick, teleport. Oh, wow, the 3-3 three misses. He dropped that combo, and that's going to be a mistake because this could be the match. The EX is, he's in reset mode now. Here it comes. This should do it. No, Maxter drops the combo. Wow. It was a month ago, and I barely remember what happened, and some of this is still shocking me. Hellfire takes it. Bad teleport again. And Pimp Ouija has to break. He drops the bombs trying to set this up. And it does. Neutral nice. Jump. Back two. Here we go. Into the net. Teleports behind him. Jumps over. Nothing doing. Just a block string. Trying to build some meter. Pimpuigi just trying to use that one pressure. And there's that forward. Oh, wow. Naked spear.
Unpunished,
though. That was a mistake by Maxter. But this could be it. He's got the meter to do it. And Scorpion has to break. Bad spin. Teleport. And this is going to do it. Yep, EX drops the other bomb, net, and that is going to do it. So Maxter responds with a full, with a very good win, an authoritative win is what I was looking for.
Yes, the first two, he was a loose cannon. He settled down there, and he brings it.
Wow, that's good. I'm glad to hear that, CD Jr., that Maxter's doing so well. When you get the chance, please pass on the message. Tell him I said Happy New Year, Happy Holidays, the whole nine to him. Tell him I'm glad he's doing well, and we hope to see him soon. Okay, so naked spear out of Scorpion there. Pimpuigi just trying, I don't know why he's trying to zone, and he has to break there. So now Maxter really at the advantage because he's got the meter to do this, and this could be a lot of damage, and it's going to do a lot of damage. This could do it. Yep, that's going to be the round. Pretty quick, pretty easy. Almost a flawless victory. I think he blocked one hit. Yeah, now he's got the meter to do this. He's in the corner. Neutral jump, jump kick, and Scorpion has to break. Forward four misses. He's caught in the net. This could do it. Nope, he doesn't have the meter to do it just yet. But yeah, he keeps up the pressure. Pimpuigi just at a disadvantage and just throws out a naked spear, not really knowing how to respond to this. This is going to do it, though. The jump kick takes it, and Maxter advances. Commercial coming up. So the next match, it's a Pool C match with Mike Metroid, who last time you saw him, he had beaten Newbie to send Newbie to the loser's bracket. And by the way, at this point in the tournament, Newbie was wrecking shop through the loser's bracket.
Yes.
He really got his money's worth by once he got sent to the loser's bracket, where he beat Mason Campbell, KT Smith, RTO Toxic, MC Peanuts, and then we'll let you know who we beat after that, because I think I may have recorded some of those matches too. But again, we have Mike Metroid, and this match here is against our random select man, Check. So, Mike Metroid using Cage just to start things up. And, you know, obviously Check spends a lot of time learning a lot of characters, getting in-depth with all of them, learning them on a high level. You know, obviously we've all seen his combo videos. He knows how to use a lot of these combos effectively in tournament, in practical manners. So what do you think about this? Who do you think wins this?
From the way he's playing, I'm looking at Check taking this. He's taking it pretty convincingly.
Yeah, Czech does win. He actually doesn't lose again until he meets Detroit Ballin.
Yeah.
Wow, almost 8 o'clock. We really need to get some food.
Yeah.
So I'm going to go. You finish up with this match, yep. And I'm going to go talk to my wife about ordering some food.
Okay. And obviously he takes first. And he's just going for the rematch. Both guys trying to play a little aggressive. Kenzie's taking the first round of the second match. Push back. I'm going to have to start playing Kenzie, I think.
Why Kenzie?
I got to learn every character. Every character. No more one or two guys. This way I can random every time against everybody. I don't care if it's the final round and top prize is 10 grand. You're getting random.
Mike Metro dropping the corner combo there, but he does, and unfortunately, Kenshi unable to see that nutcracker coming.
No, the nutcracker, I mean, it's got that reach. And that's it.
Yeah, Czech takes that match.
Yeah, you are old. Unlike me.
Okay, so this next match is a pool C match, and it was actually a pretty hype match. A lot of people were looking forward to this. This is one of the considered to be one of the best reptile players out there, and quite possibly, I believe, maybe one of the only Asian Mortal Kombat players I've seen in a long time. You know, we had Justin Wong, who played, I think, pretty much for PDP
for a week.
He said it was a month. It was a month adventure, and that's cool. But sticking with it, one of the best reptile players out there is Citizen Snips versus Detroit Ballin. No, you can't forget about him. No. I do wish Citizen Snips was on here to see this, though.
Yes.
Snips is very good. I mean, I did not know him at one of the Salty Battles tournaments, so he did not get proper placement. And, man, did he rip all the way through his pool. He really played well. Look at this. Detroit Ball and not doing so well against Snips here. But he's got him in the corner. This could do some damage. It's going to do a lot of damage.
That's a lot.
Yeah. Sets that up very well. But he gets
out of there. Got out.
Wow!
Takes the first.
I think that was
the first is with losses.
Yeah. That's a forward 4-3-4 into the skull, EX skull. You want to explain to Foz why we don't have game sound? I've done it every time.
While recording the scenes and all the footage, there was problems with the sound card, the capture board, with drivers, which didn't allow for the sound to be recorded. So there is no sound. There's only commentary over it.
What's going on? Mortal Monday in the stream. Good to see you, bro. We should have 300 viewers today for this.
Yes.
I'm upset about this. Hell, we even started relatively on time for me.
Yep.
So Detroit going to Molina here. I'm actually kind of surprised, Detroit, that you went with Molina and not Jax in this match. Ah, Citizen Snips. There he is.
Hey.
Taking out Detroit Bull and Shang with his reptile. Oh, wow. See, and this is why we need Detroit to come back for Winter Brawl, because there are so many players that he competed so well with here. There was just epic matches. Forget about that want revenge or whatever. Everybody got to know Detroit, and he's a great guy and a good, you know, became a pretty cool friend of a lot of people here, including CD Jr.
Yes.
You know, and look at this. Citizen Snips, one round from sending Detroit to losers. But it'd just be cool to have him there, just because there's so many guys he competes so well with here, and there would just be epic matches and great matches to commentate on.
Yes.
And to have him here just to have some, you know, have a good time.
Here we go. This is the turning point.
Yeah, this is where things get ugly. That's awesome to hear, CD Jr. CD Jr. saying that Detroit is his brother from another mother. So that's definitely cool to hear. And Shock is also right. It would be great to get him and Morty there. You know, I mean, imagine a tournament, right, where Detroit comes out, and if he wins, wow.
Yeah, that would.
If CD Jr. wins, even more wow, because that would set up a best of three, a potential best of three at final round. I mean, talk about hype.
It would be equivalent to a WrestleMania.
Oh, my God. It would be insane. It would have to happen.
I have a feeling that's how it might turn out.
Yeah, that's exactly. It would be a best of three at final round.
Let me ask you this. I'm going to ask everybody out there. All the tournaments that are have been considered majors in anywhere in the country, has anybody from that area where the major was held actually won the tournament for their area?
Well, yeah. I mean, if you count the Northeast, I mean, CD Jr. took Summer Jam.
Summer Jam, okay.
You know, so...
SCR was a Chicago native, right?
I don't remember.
16-bit.
Honestly. Yeah, yeah.
You got Rio in Arizona.
Yeah, Rio won Arizona.
Didn't Art win up in Canada?
I think so. Wow, bad ball there by Detroit. But the Punisher fortunately able to break it. Good uppercut by Snips there. Wow. Once again, Snips. You know, right now Detroit is at match. At match point. Detroit has the ability to break there. Both players, probably. Right now, both players. I wish I could just show video of what the players looked like. Both of these guys were sweating bullets. Unbelievable. Hype match. Look at the way that ended. Unbelievable. Okay. What's going on, Paulo? Good to see you in the stream.
What's up there, Paulo?
Commercial incoming, guys.
Well, the Romo failure is definitely going to happen. Cowboys are going to get their asses whooped.
Okay, so up next, this is a match I think that was seriously hyped up.
Yes, this was.
This is a quarterfinal match in the winner's bracket of Pool D. These two have known each other for a really long time. And to my knowledge, they haven't always been on the friendliest of terms.
No.
But this match, this is Pig of the Hut versus EMP Tom Brady. And, you know, it's funny because in a way you'd expect Brady to be used to this match because Rio played Molina for so long.
Yeah, but no.
You know, obviously we all know how this match ends up because we know where Pig's placement was. See, that forward four, he should have ended that forward four into a freeze because you can cancel that.
Mm-hmm. Got the throw.
Yep.
And then he's going to sigh.
That wow, going for that EX slide and the armor not quite doing what he wanted it to do. And there he lands that sigh. He's just pretty convincingly taking this round. Jump in into an air sigh, and that does take the round very convincingly with authority. Yeah, I think it does go into that first two. Again, we don't have Rob here to verify. I will say, though, you know, that was one thing that. Yeah, shock, it would be, but he did look for forward four there. He just didn't cancel it to freeze. But that anyway, I was saying that's one thing I definitely missed was having Dark Rob at NEC.
Yes, that's. I was surprised he didn't show, but you know, I know he's got his things he's going on. So
yeah, he's got things he has to take care of. So, X-ray. X-ray, knee to the jaw. Look at that.
And?
Pig of the Hut taking the first match.
Of course.
And a fatality.
Yeah.
See, now I was a little confused by this choice here. Tom Brady hadn't used Kung Lao in a while going into this.
He went over to the Johnny Cage after this, after the sub for a while.
That's funny, Art. Yeah, Pig kind of blew up a lot of people in this game. And I expect he's going to do very well at final round as well. Pretty much any tournament he goes to, he's going to do very well. But yeah, he had been playing Johnny Cage, I think, and I'm not sure why Tom went with Kung Lao. I guess maybe because Kung Lao is pretty much, you know, considered universally to want to be one of the easier characters to use, and he used them so extensively beforehand that. Maybe he just felt confident with him.
But it wasn't to be.
Yeah, that was pretty much going to do it no matter what. Any EX would have beaten it. And the EX teleport, a teleport kick, would have beaten that there, even if it didn't. Yeah, you know, Art, it's funny because I saw those matches when you played... Pig on your stream online. I saw those matches and I was like, wow, I did not know Pig was this good. Shock saying Tom just got bodied.
Not really a way you want to play against Melina.
No, not really.
You got to get up in her. You can't let her dominate with those size.
As I said, this was just, to me anyway, this was just a puzzling choice by Tom Brady. I don't know why he went with Kung Lao. Again, maybe it's just because he felt that it was a better zoning match for Kung Lao as opposed to Johnny Cage, who has to try to get up in her face. There it is. He was looking for
he
that.
He was waiting for that.
Definitely looking for that. But again, even in that scenario, he could have done more damage. I mean, she still had the ability to break. Pig could have broken. But I'm not, you know, I don't really like that choice there, blowing the entire meter to do that little damage.
That little damage, no. Because now you're going into it, she's full, you're not.
Yeah, see, now look at the advantage that Pig is at just with that one x-ray. And they were trolling each other with x-rays, I think.
Yeah, I have a tendency to do that myself. You don't look at the other player's meter sometimes.
You know what Dark Rob says? Dark Rob says you hate your meter.
No, I don't like meter.
He says you hate your meter and you just want to get rid of it as quickly as possible.
It's annoying. I don't want meter. I don't need x-rays. Just give me a couple of EXs, that's all. And I get them done right away. 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, you get your EX bars, and there you go.
She's just chopping away with those sides.
Yep, just chip, chip, chip.
And that's how it's going to go.
That was a good read there by Brady, though. But nothing doing. And we got a second fatality. And Pig advances, and that win right there actually advanced Pig of the Hut to the winner's final of his bracket. That would be Pool D. So in that match, Pig of the Hut advanced to the Pool D winner's final. Okay, so
No, that was... They messed up Matt with that match.
Alright, so now, the next match, the record, again, I wasn't doing all the recording throughout this, but, and it's a shame, but, nah, I don't have enough of it. So the next match is actually another Tom Brady match, and this is against, another Canadian player, more well known for his UMK3 skills, And I think that secretly, no doubt, is his stalker. I'm talking about B.A. Winter Wars versus EMP Tom Brady. Gee, how'd you guys guess when I said no doubt might secretly be his stalker? Now, just some insight with Winter Wars. Winter Wars is a keyboard player and actually has a custom-built keyboard with converters to be able to play MK9 on a keyboard on a PS3.
Yeah, I saw that. He's another Canadian player, too.
And yeah, Shock, you're absolutely right. I mean, he follows Winter Wars. He loves Winter Wars. And Brady looking for that.
Tom loving those x-rays.
Loves those x-rays. Does he follow it up? He should be able to at least get the one. Yeah, he connects with at least one hit to win it. Oh, okay. The Shady X, the Shady 9XD says it's the converter. And what I mean by custom built, just, you know, with the converter and the way he carries it around is you know, it's pretty, it looks pretty custom. But if it's a standard keyboard, it's pretty cool, though. Regardless, to see somebody using a converter and playing on a keyboard like that is pretty cool. So, Tom Brady taking the first match against Winter Wars. Shock saying that a keyboard is better than a hitbox.
I would, I'd have to agree with him on that.
Stick is better than everything.
Stick beats everything.
In my opinion. I mean, I know Shock ultimately prefers a keyboard. But Winter Wars, you know, pretty convincing in this round so far. He's dictating the match, so to speak. And with an uppercut, he takes that first round.
Probably didn't break because he wants to have that x-ray.
Well, you know, Brady says all the time that in this game, meter equals life. Connects with that overhead.
Not a lot of Kung Lao's really abuse that overhead. It's really a key part to Kung Lao.
You know what's funny? You know who's abuse? You know who's trying to use that more often? Back before it got better was Classy Sasquatch.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Who has become a well-versed Scorpion player.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I haven't seen him. I've seen his Nightwolf. I've seen his Kung Lao.
He's got a good Nightwolf. And Brady coming right back, taking that second round. Not as convincingly as Winter Wars took the first round, but still with authority.
And the next race, still.
Well, both characters, well, too.
Tom don't want to go away with that until the end.
Well, yeah, but the problem here is that, you know, Cyrax has three bars, yeah. And he can, you know, that can drain his life very quickly.
Good jump.
Good read on the teleport there. Looking for it. Wow.
Oh, that's not.
It was a good read on the teleport there by Winter Wars, and that he sniffed it out with that uppercut.
He's patiently holding on to that X-ray.
Yes, he is.
Could have broke it, but nope. And
he's just looking for that jump. Jump over, nothing doing. And there it is.
Yes, X-ray.
He saw it. He was waiting for it. He knew Winter Wars would. Now he's going to catch the back end of the combo. And the kick.
And he gets it.
The flip over. A little bit of life.
Oh.
One kick, and that does it. So Tom Brady taking that match, advancing in the loser's bracket.
Literally by the skin of his balls.
So Brady's next match would eventually be Arturo Sanchez, actually. Because I'm not 100% sure we recorded. I am. I think we did. I'm pretty sure we did. But all right, guys. Commercial incoming. So, continuing to move on, the next match is actually a Pool A match. Yes, it is. And I believe this is a Pool A quarterfinal match. And I got to tell you, we probably waited for 2.5 hours to get him here to play this match. This is VVV CD Jr. versus LBNY Chris G. And I'll be right back.
Yeah, pretty much in this match, being that Chris G knocked me out, CD Jr. pretty much avenges me. And it wasn't even beknownst to him. A lot of jumping around by CD over there, not a norm for him. Yeah, he's not like Tom. There ain't no other person out there that's like a Tom. Punch, 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 punch. No dash, no follow-up with the dash punch, but got him in the corner and took him first round. Ooh, kicked him in the face.
Okay, so I'm back.
Yes, Garrick, there was no sound because the sound card did not have drivers. So they were faulty drivers, therefore we didn't capture the sound.
Yeah, Christy was not happy after this, was not happy after this. Junior just continuing to apply the pressure. Really not letting Chris breathe. And using that armor to get through the ball. What's going on, Sushi? No, no one's getting down on Chris, actually. You know, Chris is a friend of mine, and you know, I feel it when he loses, man. I know, believe me, I get down on myself when I lose, too.
Yeah, I don't think there's anybody here that I don't personally begrudge a guy for getting mad when he loses. I mean, nobody here that enters a tournament with the intent of losing.
Yeah, no. He. And we're going to get that fatality out of CD Jr.
These bitches cheating.
So the next match is another highly anticipated match, a loser's bracket match from Pool D. This is the losers semifinals between T.S. Saban, between Arturo Sanchez and EMP Tom Brady.
Yeah, CD, I think I'm going to do the same thing with the tanning. Also going to walk around with an American flag over my shoulder from now on.
So he trades that. That's not a great trade there for... That's not a great trade for Reptile to trade the spit for a freeze. Or for a ball either. He's still going to wind up taking the damage. Brady just trying to zone. Try to not give Arturo a chance to get in. That X-ray, nothing doing though. Blows the entire meter. And that's the Brady special x-ray. That's where he drops a clone and immediately fires off that x-ray, hoping that his opponent's going to back up trying to get away from it. And that's a bad trade there, right there, for Brady, because that was a round winner for Arturo. Nothing doing on the EX ball there by Arturo. He just keeps he's got to keep that clone out, though. That way Arturo can't just continue to dash and get in. That's why we're seeing so many clones. EX freeze, nothing doing. Slide, puts him on the ground, but Arturo wins the air-to-air, down four into an acid hand, nothing doing. EX slide, nothing doing. Dash in, and it gets blocked. No punish, though. 2-1-2, nothing on the freeze. EX fireball, neutral jump misses. Zoning each other out now. EX fire, freeze, nothing. EX ball, nothing. Spit, but he gets punished for it. He's going to jump in. Back 1-2-1. That sets up the mix-up. Down fours. EX slide. Nothing doing on the back end, though. And the jump kick takes it. Arturo gets the first match.
Yeah, I think, Garrick, I think he's supposed to be going to Brazil the first week of January, if I remember correctly. In fact, isn't Tom's birthday coming up? I think it was for his birthday.
No. His birthday is a month before mine.
Okay. Oh, he's not going to Brazil anymore. Salud.
That freeze in the corner misses there. That would have been some sick damage. Now you notice that he's doing nothing but walking. That's all Brady's doing is walking. Very rarely has to dash. Although he just dashed right there. Dash into an EX slide. Puts him in the corner now. Again, keeping those clones out to stop Art from being able to dash at him. Jump over, nothing. Very well-placed clone. Back 1-2-1, sets up the mix-up. 2-1-2 into free, into clone, but the EX slide goes through it. Good move by Art there. He's got to stay away from that clone. Acid hand. Wins on the air-to-air jump kick. Good round. Again, he's just trying to get a lead here with Sub-Zero and then protect it. EX slide puts Arturo in the corner. Drops that clone to keep him trapped. Slide hits first, but he catches him with a clone. 2-2-4. Does not drop a clone immediately, though. Gets a little closer and then drops the clone. Now he's got the downforce. 2-1-2, but the EX clone, the EX slide goes through the clone. 2-1-4. Oh, baits out the slide with a good clone. Yes, another good clone. Really playing well here. Good mind games in the corner. Wow, baits out another bad dash into a clone. Jump over, and Art is forced to break. Neutral jump. He's got him in the corner. Ball. 3-2, ball. Nothing doing. 2-2 in the corner by Sub-Zero. Down fours. Looking for that 2-2, but doesn't connect. Dashes into another clone. Back 1-2-1. Comes in. 2-1-2 freeze. Clone. He's got him trapped. Down fours here. Jump over into a jump punch. Clone to stop him from dashing. Just throwing ice balls here. But eats a spit. Jump over. Doesn't connect by either player. Reptile almost trapped there. Wow. Art did a great job of escaping that with the down fours.
Tom's just trying to...
Just trying to protect his lead. That's all he's trying to do.
Protect his lead.
But unfortunately, he doesn't have the lead.
And get that x-ray.
Oh, wow. Now he connects. And here it comes.
There you go.
There's that x-ray. Knew that was coming. How do you like your liver? Frozen. But Art has the meter advantage.
But it was not the right time to use the x-ray.
Just zoning him out. Down four into green hand and into acid hand. One move, and that is it. So Arturo, advances to loser's final in Pool D, knocking Tom Brady out of the tournament.
Which was allowing him to come with me to drink.
So we have a commercial incoming, guys. Stick around now. You want to be here for this match. Okay, so now, in Pool C, when the quarterfinals came, these were some of the most hype matches. People were really psyched, especially for this match. Because the next two matches that one of these players played in, they were pretty insane. I was psyched. This match actually is Detroit Ballin, and no, CD Jr., it's not you're against your brother. This is Detroit Ballin. Player two is Detroit. Player one, our random select hero, check. And once again, remember, Czech was doing nothing but random select in pools unless he made top eight. If he made top eight, what a combo. Wow, Detroit. Damn, man. Making mincemeat out of Czech. Look at this. Is this a flawless? Yes. That's funny. CD Jr. just said, nothing against you, Detroit. I just don't want to cry. That's why he doesn't want to see the match against his brother. Wow. But Detroit, unbelievable. Great matches here. You know, and Czech's no slouch, but look at this. Just setting him up. 47% and almost all of it unbreakable. Just sick. Good throw into the corner by Czech there. You know, as I was saying, Czech was not going to go, he's not going to choose any character straight out. He was going random straight through unless he made it to the top eight. Yeah, oh my god, damage. 47%, basically unbreakable. Check randoming and getting rain this time. Detroit just abusing him. And that's nothing bad against Check. I mean, you know, he is outstanding. Just Detroit just really, wow. You missed it. Detroit did a 47% unbreakable, basically unbreakable to Check when Check was using Katana. And got a flawless.
He randomed on this one.
Yeah.
I don't think he has much rain going.
No, he knows how to use rain.
Does he? Does he?
He pretty much knows how to use everybody. Oh, but he misses the lightning there.
Oh.
Outstanding. 29%. That was breakable because almost all that was hits, though. Using that soul steel to build some meter at that range. Swing and a miss on the Super Roundhouse. And Detroit Ballin, pretty much with authority and with ease, takes that match. So with that win, that puts Detroit Ballin in the winner's final, actually, of and the winner's final of Pool D, Pool C, my apologies, and sets up a match that you can see later. This next match, however, another really, really hype match, a match that a lot of people wanted to see. A lot of people were waiting for this match. You remember this match, Jimmy?
Yes.
This was, I believe, Pool B, or Pool A, maybe? Nope, Pool D. This was Pool D. This was the winner's final of Pool D. Pig of the Hut versus Ryu 48. And obviously we know who won the match because Ryu 48 went into top 8 in winners.
Yep.
I was actually pretty surprised to see Pig of the Hut go in using Kenshi, though. But I think he might have known something here that maybe Ryu 48 did not know. But he seems to be doing fairly well. I mean, as we said, Pig of the Hut is a very capable player and a very scary player.
Yeah, he zones guys out well here.
Look at that. Takes the first round. Ryu 48 just really putting the pressure on here. Now he's got him in the corner. Is not where you want to be against Sonya. And that move puts himself back in the corner. Not really a great idea against Sonya, as I said. She's Ryu 48 trying to sniff out. Definitely looking to use that EX cartwheel. Wow, the autocorrect dive kick. Lots of damage here. Damage incoming. Ends with an onion ring. Nothing doing, though. And Pig of the Hut taking the first match. Getting stuck with Kenshi. Not necessarily a bad thing for him, though.
Revolver is going to, by the way, prove Shang to be... I don't know if there is a tier past S. But the way Revolver uses him, you guys got to watch out, man.
So, more Kenshi incoming from Ryu 48 and Pig of the Hut. Now we'll see just how well Ryu 48 is able to adjust.
And he's adjusting very well right here.
Yeah, I'd say so. Resets it. Look at this. Nasty damage in the corner. Nasty damage. Wow.
Ugly.
That is why Ryu 48 is so good at this game. Using that military stance. EX cartwheel does not connect there. Look at the zoning by Pig of the Hut. Just trying to keep her out.
She's getting away in there slowly.
Yeah, but she can't dive kick against him.
Nope.
And that tells me why he picked Kenshi, because he can't dive kick. Wow, this is going to do the round. That's going to be the round. It's a good round. Good way to end the round as Kenshi. Keep her away. She can't seem to do much to get inside. So, you know, we know Ryu 48 wins this, but I'm interested to see how it happens now. That might be it, because she manages to get in. Nothing doing on the EX, but now she's inside, and this is dangerous. EX cartwheel, nothing.
Got her away again.
Yep, got to fight her way back in. EX cartwheel to get in, but Pig has enough to break. No one's got the meter yet. Dive kick, nothing, because he gets knocked out of the air. Jump over, autocorrect dive kick for a cross-up, or cross-under, whatever you want to call it. A little zoning here. That's what Pig wants to do. Wants to zone him out here. Hits a home run with the onion rings. And Ryu 48, able to adjust and take the match, tying it up to go to make that best of three happen. We got Pig of the Hut 1, VSM Ryu 48 1. And you guys know, obviously we know who wins, but let's see who Pig decides to go with here. I'm guessing Molina.
That's what I would think. He rematches. He doesn't change up.
No, he does not. It's not a bad move, sticking with him. You know, he did beat him once. Using that EX cartwheel to get inside. Puts him in the corner, and the dive kick gets in. Yep, the kiss to reset it. Puts him on, plants him on the ground. Knocked down by the shoulder, though. Gets out with the EX cartwheel. No meter, though. Military stance to get back inside. Down one. Cartwheel. You got him inside now. This is a lot of damage. Chip damage to win the round. Ryu 48 on match point. Nothing doing on the block string. EX cartwheel does not beat the EX shoulder. About even on meter here. Kenshi building meter quickly. Onion rings and gets nothing. Good zoning by Pig. Really keeping her away. Wins the air-to-air jump kick. Looking for that EX cartwheel. And he expected it, but gets popped up anyway. Going to do some big damage here. Military stands into cartwheel, nothing, but wins the air-to-air, and Pig has to break. Gets that EX cartwheel this time. Resets it with the kiss. Nothing. Swing and a miss with the with the sword.
Swing and a miss, and that's
it. That is it. So that is how Ryu 48 gets it done. That was the winner's final of Pool D putting Ryu 48 into top 8. So just a quick commercial incoming, guys, and we'll be right back at it.
Seems like
Mel says nothing's open.
Yeah.